My grandmother, Velma Agnes Hill, went to school in this building in 1940. This one-story wood structure is located in Wade, Mississippi, and is nearly 100 years old. It likely won't make it another five without intervention, and even then, the majority of it can't be salvaged. I called her today to see if she had any specific memories about going to school here. She didn't have much to say. She's almost 86 and has battled cancer for the past decade or so. But there were two very pointed things she had to say about it. "I just remember how much I hated walking there," she told me. Like many Depression-era kids of the 30s and 40s, she was dirt poor. Her dad died when she was a little girl, so she was subject to a single-parent household. She's told me stories of having a literal dirt floor. Dirt. So having a family vehicle was clearly out of the question. "Son, it was so cold. I don't think it gets that cold here anymore. But boy, it was cold. We had to walk. We had no other choice." Clearly, walking to this building in the brutal cold doesn't harken back fond memories for her. She doesn't remember any of the kids she went to school with. She made sure to tell me they're likely dead now. "Damn, Granny. I do remember my teacher," she told me. "Her name was Miss Carter." I did some digging and learned that Miss Susie Carter was one of the first teachers appointed by the trustees at the Wade Consolidated School. Miss Carter taught there for 37 years. "She told us to bathe and clean ourselves before coming to school," she said. "She didn't want to smell us." My grandma laughed so hard when telling me this that she started coughing, probably from her smoker's lung, but I like to think that her mind flashed back to the moment Miss Carter scolded them for not bathing before stepping into her classroom. That's it. That's all she remembers about this building. In fact, when I told her I shot this video of it, she thought it had already collapsed. My grandma's lived through the Great Depression, World War II, 14 presidents, multiple hurricanes, including Hurricane Katrina, where she waded through flooding waters, and now another global pandemic. I don't think I could walk a mile in her shoes. Here's to social distancing and the things you learn about your grandma by just asking where she went to school.